Finding that business class award flight could be a pain, but what if you could search for 30 days of award availability all in a single click? They call it the Mega Search, and I'm going to go over how to use this tool and all of its other features as we dive into an award flight sweet spot to Europe for just 30 to 35,000 points one way. So be sure to stick around for that. And now I know that there are a lot of different award search tools just popping up everywhere. However, today we are going to figure out if this one is worth keeping around. Now this award search tool is simply called AwardTool, and you access it by going to awardtool.com. And so this is what the homepage looks like. And as you can see, there's a lot of different functions, a lot of different buttons. Well, I'm not going to beat around the bush. We're going to go straight to the mega search so we can see what this is all about, because I know that's why you came here. So this tool is fairly straightforward to use. You know, it's a regular search here. So you put in the airports. And so the sweet spot I'm talking to you about today is JFK to Lisbon for just 35,000 points, give or take. And so you've got the drop down menu to search just for business class or all kinds of combinations. And now it is a 30 entry search. So that means if it's just between two airports, I could search for 30 days of award availability. However, if I add an additional airport, it'll be 15 days. And as I add more airports, I'm able to search fewer days, but I can search multiple airports all at once. And so there is a great degree of flexibility within this tool as well. And then down here, you can select which programs you want to search with. And so I don't like that it's all abbreviations, but you can just highlight and see which programs they are. And so this sweet spot I'm talking about is with Avianca Life Miles. And now I can search with another program, but I'm only able to search two of them with the free membership here. You have to upgrade to Pro in order to search for more programs all at once. So let's just search on Avianca. So I got 27 results, and this showed up less than 20 seconds really. And now you've got all these filters to make it easier to find what you're looking for. And now I see some things for 28,000 points. And so I know that some of this is going to be economy on the long route. So I'm going to adjust this premium cabin percentage. So that way it'll show me the business class for the USA to Europe route. And then from here, you can sort by lowest points available, or you also have the date filter here, and you can further adjust however you wish with all these different filters available. And then you can look through all of your results here, has all the pertinent information. And now this is a real-time search. So all this award availability, it's not cached, it's not old results that was found previously. This is what's available now. And so if you hit this drop-down arrow, it'll pull up all your different transfer partner options, and you can simply click on this Life Miles logo and it will take you to lifemiles.com. I went ahead and double checked to make sure that award availability was there, and sure enough, here it is, JFK to Brussels on Brussels Airlines in business class, and then to Lisbon from there. So that's a good sweet spot to know about, and I will tell you, most of the time it's going to be kind of relatively last minute availability, but you can also find some random dates like around January time frame on the off season. And so that's the mega search, and it's very powerful. However, it's not even my favorite part of this website. Now I'm going to share that with you, but first let me just say that this mega search, it's only available 3 times per day for free users. In order to use it unlimited amount of times, you will need to upgrade to the Pro subscription. So to get it out of the way, the Pro subscription is either $10.99 a month or $84.99 for a year subscription. There's currently a temporary promotion going on, but I did secure my own $20 off code that will be permanent for you, and that code is NMT20, and so that will keep it at the $65 per year price. And now I do have an affiliate link down in the description for you, so if you decide to get a membership with AwardTool at all, be sure to click through that link first. That'd be extremely beneficial for me at no cost to you. But let me first run through some of these other features of this tool to see if this actually makes sense for you. So there's a lot of features in this tool, but this is how I recommend that you go about it for the best user experience, because you can kind of get lost in the sauce pretty quickly here. I first want to highlight that AwardTool advertises that they search through 22 different programs. They search essentially all the same ones that PointsYeah also searches. However, AwardTool also searches British Airways, and they state they search Singapore Airlines as well. However, I can say by using this tool for a little while now, the British Airways and Singapore capability is very hit or miss. It can be very glitchy. Sometimes it picks them up, sometimes it doesn't, and I very rarely see any Singapore results. But understanding that it is hit or miss, it's still nice that they may pick up some of it and save you an extra search. And now their search function also has an awesome capability if you have the Pro subscription. It's a 24 entry search. And now this is, again, is their real-time search. It's not cached results. So like the mega search, it is 24 entries, not just 24 days. So if it's a single pair of airports, you can search 24 days at a time. If you search 3 airports, then it goes down down to 12 days and so on. And so I'm going to search this Hawaii sweet spot from New York all the way over to Honolulu. So now let's hit search. Now every time I finish the search, it gives me this pop-up, which doesn't make sense because I didn't use the panorama function to begin with, but just kind of click out of this and it will give you all of the different search results again within 20 seconds or less. And as you can see, this awesome sweet spot for just 10,000 points over from New York all the way to Honolulu, that's an incredible deal. So if you're looking for a different airline, you have all these different filters. If you're looking for a specific date, you can go through the dates here. You can limit the number of taxes if you're having to deal with flights to Europe, etc. And now the special sauce that I love about this award tool is this check panorama calendar view here. And so it doesn't show up on every route, but when it does, it's pretty special. So let's click on it and it will bring you to this routes feature here. Now, I don't really recommend that you search directly on routes because it can get pretty confusing. And so I'd rather you search on the flight search function and then make your way over here. So AwardTool essentially tracks a lot of different routes between different airports and it kind of keeps tabs on them for you. And so if we go to the Turkish Miles and Smiles program, it has all these different hits for this route, New York to Honolulu. And so if we go to calendar view, there's nothing in August, but as we slip through here, we can see that there is a nice calendar view showing award availability. And it has stars for when it's a direct route, as far as no stars whenever there's a connection. So you simply just click on the date and it will pull up the routing here for you and you can go from there. And so I think this is an incredible feature to have an award calendar on all these different routes. Now, to be 1000% truthful with you, I was looking at other routes and sometimes you would see an old calendar that wasn't updated recently. And whenever you would click on something, it will kind of show you briefly and then it will just go away. Oh, like that. And so unfortunately, some of these routes can get out of date. And so you do just kind of have to pick at it. And now you can request a refresh and that will kind of update the award availability, but that can take around 20 minutes and they send you an email when it's done. So that's the routes feature. Now there's two more features that I really want to highlight about this tool. First, there's this panorama feature, which AwardTool says offers a more comprehensive view in comparison to Explore, but otherwise they are very similar. They both let you search 90 days of award availability at once and they are cached results. And so they're not the most up-to-date information, but it gives you a lot of different ideas. It's very similar to PointsYeah's Daydream Explorer. For instance, I'm doing a search for the west coast of the United States over to Africa, and then it'll pull up all kinds of different routes that are available. And now, so that's one cool thing about AwardTool is that they separate it by west coast, east coast, etc. However, if you just try to search for the United States, it only lets you do the whole United States, and it doesn't do the United States excluding Hawaii, because sometimes if you're traveling to Asia, it will just pull up a bunch of Honolulu award flights, which are a lot cheaper than others, then you have to sift through that, etc. But anyway, so it's pulled up all these award flights from the West Coast over to Africa. You can then filter by business class, however you like, and then all these other filters are available for you as well. And like I said, these are old flights that they found, so you'll see that they were seen hours ago, a day ago. I've seen as long as a month ago, for instance, it's 2 months ago, so there are some really old, not helpful stuff in here. And then again, if you click on it, sometimes it'll just say it's not available. There's no options finding it. And there's not a real easy way to do the live search from here. And so the cracks start to show a little bit here, how there's just a little bit of glitches or just not as user-friendly things that you would like. Nonetheless, the Explore feature is a good way to get ideas as far as what routes may exist. And then you can go through the search function and actually do that 24 entry search, which would give you a lot more helpful results. And then the last thing I want to highlight is its hotel features. Now, I won't spend that much time on it, but they cover the major four brands. It's a straightforward tool, but the special feature I like about it so much is that you can go into any hotel and you can pull up the award calendar for it. So it'll default to the list view, but then you can go to calendar view and voila, it'll give you a nice calendar that you can sift through instead of having to go through each hotel site individually. And so that's just one thing I liked about this hotel feature on AwardTool specifically. So that hotel calendar is free, and just to recap some other free features. So there is the original search function, which lets you search 4 days at a time for a pair of airports or 4 airports at once at 1 day at a time. In terms of the Explore and the Panorama, it only lets you search for 90 days of up to today. And so it doesn't give you a full year like you would expect it or hope it to. And like I said, you get three of the mega search, and then you don't really get the 24 entry search. It lets you search for 12 days, but literally just the 12 days from today is all. So is this tool worth it? I think it's a tremendously powerful tool, and there is a natural tendency to try to compare this tool to PointsYeah. And that's because they have a lot of similar functions. However, if you ask me, I think PointsYeah is really just meant to be a free tool for users. And I think it does that better than AwardTool, simply because I think PointsYeah looks a little bit cleaner, but I also have the bias that I've been using that tool a lot more over the past year. But AwardTool's most unique and most useful features is locked behind a paywall. And so if you look at it from a paid tools perspective, you're really forced to compare this tool to Seats.Aero. And I think an argument can be made that AwardTool may be better for users than Seats.Aero, because I believe Seats.Aero kind of fails its users from smaller home airports. I know a lot of the best deals come from larger airports, but there are still plenty of deals to be had from the smaller airports, which AwardTool does pick up. Plus, they have more award programs that they're able to track and search. So I think in some or in many ways, AwardTool is a lot more powerful and useful than Seats.Aero for some users. However, its power is clouded by some of the glitches that I showed you earlier, and that really affects its perceived accuracy. And I've also noticed that whenever you use AwardTool too much, like if you have too many windows and go in full research mode, sometimes it will crash on you with this sad face. Luckily, it is easily recoverable just by hitting the refresh button, but nonetheless, you can kind of still see cracks there. But even with that said, I think its utility is so great that if you are in the market of looking for an award search tool to invest in, I think Seats.Aero is definitely worth a try for at least a month, and I think AwardTool is right up there with it to try for at least a month to see which one sits with you better before going in for a recurring subscription, or if you want to dive into the annual subscription, whichever you pick. Just make sure to use one of the links down in the description. And let me know what you think about these tools in the comments below. And now if you want to hear more about Seats.Aero or PointsYeah, be sure to check out these videos above. My name is Michael with Nurse Michael Travels. I'll see you on the next one.